Dear students, I am going to share a topic with you that is from Chapter 3, Machines of Class 10th. Part A, Machines, Technical Terms and Levers. Machine. In simple language, machine is a device which is used to make our work easier. For example, in daily life, we cut vegetable or fruit with the help of knife. So, knife can also be treated as a machine. By the name machine, it is not a complicated device. It may be simple also. And in scientifically language, if we want to define, then a machine is a device which is used either to overcome a large resistive force, that is load, at some point by applying a small force effort at a convenient point and in desired direction, or to obtain a gain in speed. Functions or uses of simple machine. First, to lift a heavy load by applying less effort. In such a case, the machine acts as a force multiplier. For example, when a jack is used to lift a car, effort is much less than the load. In the diagram, you can see a person is lifting the car with the help of a jack. He is applying very less effort as compared to the weight of the car. That means the effort applied is multiplied to overcome the load. So, machine can act as a force multiplier. Second example is to change the point of application of effort to a convenient point. For example, the rear wheel of a bicycle is rotated by applying the effort on the pedal. Just imagine a bicycle without pedal. So, a person has to apply the force on the rear wheel directly, which is very difficult. So, the machine, that is the pedal, can help us to change the point of application of force to a convenient one. Third, to change the direction of effort to a convenient direction. For example, when a single fixed pulley is used to lift the bucket from a well, the effort is applied in downward direction. See in the diagram, the boy is applying the force in downward direction, but if pulley is not used, in order to pull the bucket from the well, the person has to apply the force in upward direction, which is very difficult, because the weight of the bucket will pull the rope or string in downward direction. So, the force to be applied in downward direction is easier than to apply in upward direction. Fourth, to obtain a gain in speed, that is to obtain a greater movement of load by a smaller movement of effort. That is, in this case, the machine acts as a speed multiplier. For example, when a pair of scissors is used to cut the cloth, its blades move longer on cloth while its handles move a little. That is, the displacement covered by the handle is less than the displacement covered by the cloth, by the blades on the cloth, because the length of blades is longer than the length of handles. It is important to note down that a machine cannot be used as a force multiplier and a speed multiplier simultaneously. It works either as a force multiplier or a speed multiplier. For example, if one machine is used, that means it will be working as a force multiplier or a speed multiplier, not both at the same time. To know about machine, we need to know some technical terms related to machine. They are as follows. First, load. The resistive or opposing force to be overcome by a machine is known as load. Effort. The force applied on the machine to overcome the load. Now, mechanical advantage is the ratio of the load to the effort. So, its formula becomes mechanical advantage is equal to load upon effort. According to this, mechanical advantage of a machine can be less than 1, equal to 1, or more than 1. Why? Because it is a fractional value. So, its answer or value depends on the value of numerator and denominator. If numerator is bigger than the denominator, then the value will be greater than 1. If numerator is less than the effort, then value will be less than 1. And if the numerator and denominator are equal, then the value will be equal to 1. For example, here, mechanical advantage is greater than 1 if effort is less than load. That means the denominator is less than the numerator. This kind of machine act as a force multiplier. That means it multiply the effort to overcome the load. Or we can say in this case the effort is less than the load. Mechanical advantage is equal to 1. If effort is equal to load, that means the numerator and denominator are equal. So they both will cancel each other and they result in 1. This kind of machine is used to change the direction of effort. Mechanical advantage is less than 1 if the effort is more than the load. That means the denominator is greater than the numerator. This kind of machine acts as a speed multiplier. That means the distance traveled by the load is greater than the distance traveled by the effort. Velocity ratio. It is the ratio of the velocity of effort to the velocity of load, or the ratio of displacement of effort to the displacement of load. So it can be written as VR is equal to VE upon VL, that is DE upon DL. Now here also, according to this formula of velocity ratio, the velocity ratio of a machine can be less than 1, equal to 1, or greater than 1 according to the values of numerator and denominator. Velocity ratio is greater than 1 if the displacement of load is less than the displacement of effort. And in this case, the machine acts as a force multiplier. Velocity ratio is equal to 1 if the displacement of load is equal to the displacement of effort. So again, this kind of machine is used to change the direction of effort. Velocity ratio is less than 1 if displacement of load is more than the displacement of effort. And in this case, the machine acts as a speed multiplier. So in all these cases, you have understood that machine can act either as a force multiplier or a speed multiplier or none of these. And if it is not acting as a force multiplier or speed multiplier, then it is used to change the direction of effort. Work input. The work done on the machine by the effort. And work output is the work done by the machine on the load. Seventh, efficiency. It is the ratio of the work done on the load by the machine to the work done on the machine by the effort. So efficiency is equal to work output upon work input. Or in percentage case, it is given as work output upon work input into 100%. Remember, mechanical advantage, velocity ratio, or efficiency of a machine has no unit, as these quantities are pure ratio. That means the units of numerator and denominators will cancel each other. So there are no unit for mechanical advantage, velocity ratio, or efficiency. And it is important to note, due to friction and weight of the moving parts of a machine of a given design, its velocity ratio does not change, but its mechanical advantage decreases, and so its efficiency also decreases. Since the velocity ratio depends on the design of the machine, for example, in scissor, the blades are longer than the handle, but in case of pliers, the handles are longer than the blades. So the velocity ratio depends on the design of the machine, which we cannot change at all. So velocity ratio of machine remains same. It does not change, but due to the friction in its parts and weight of the moving parts, the mechanical advantage and efficiency of the machine in actual cases are always less than 1 or 100%. Principle of a machine. For an ideal machine, that means in ideal case, output energy is equal to input energy. But for an actual machine, output energy is always less than the input energy. That is, there is some loss of energy. And there are some reasons behind this, that why this loss of energy takes place. That is, first, moving parts of machine are neither weightless nor frictionless. There is the weight of the parts as well as the parts have some friction. So, some part of energy is utilized in overcoming that friction or to lift up or to move those parts of the machine which have some weight. Second, the string, if used in a machine, is not perfectly elastic. Third, its different parts are not perfectly rigid. The percentage of rigidity may vary from one kind of part to other. And it is important to note, no machine is 100% efficient. This happens due to this reason only, that some part of energy is utilized in overcoming the friction or in overcoming or lifting the parts of the machine. So, if a machine is 80% efficient, it implies that 80% of the total energy supplied to it is obtained as useful energy, and the remaining 20% is lost in overcoming friction, and it appears as heat energy in different parts. For example, when car moves with the help of fuel, the fuel provides it energy, that is input energy, but we can't obtain the 100% of input energy in the form of 100% of mechanical energy. That means the movement of the car, some part of that energy is utilized in running the engine, which has different parts. That means that energy, some part of energy is utilized in overcoming the friction in the parts of the engine, which turns in the form of heat energy, due to which the engine car or the engine of the car gets heated up. Now, what is the relation between efficiency, mechanical advantage, and velocity ratio? Mechanical advantage is equal to velocity ratio multiplied by efficiency. Some examples of machine. First, levers. A lever is a rigid bar which is capable of turning about a fixed point. It works on a principle load into load arm is equal to effort into effort arm. This lever, the concept of lever, will be more clear when you learn about its different types. And for a lever, mechanical advantage is equal to load upon effort or effort arm upon load arm. Mechanical advantage is equal to 1 if effort arm is equal to load arm. Mechanical advantage is greater than 1 if effort arm is greater than the load arm. And mechanical advantage is less than 1 if effort arm is less than the load arm. There are 3 kinds of levers: class 1 lever, class 2 lever, and class 3 lever. So here we are going to discuss about class 1 lever. In such a lever, fulcrum is in between load and effort. And depending upon the position of fulcrum, mechanical advantage and velocity ratio can be greater than 1, equal to 1, or less than 1. See, in this diagram, fulcrum is in between effort and load, and it is not necessary that fulcrum is just or exactly at the midpoint. It may be near effort or near load. So the length of effort arm and load arm may be equal or unequal. Effort arm is the distance between the effort and fulcrum, whereas the load arm is the distance of the load from the fulcrum. So if the fulcrum is in the middle, then in that case load arm will be equal to effort arm. So mechanical advantage will be equal to 1. For example, in this seesaw, the fulcrum is in the midpoint, exactly between the load and effort. That means the load arm and effort arms are equal, due to which the mechanical advantage will be equal to 1, because mechanical advantage is equal to effort arm upon load arm. On the other hand, if we see this pliers, then the handles are longer than the blades. So on the handles, we need to apply the effort. So we can say effort arm is greater, whereas the load arm is smaller. So if effort arm is greater than the load arm, then mechanical advantage will be greater than 1. And in case of scissors, the blades are longer than the handles. That means the load arm is greater than the effort arm. So mechanical advantage is equal to effort arm upon load arm. That means less than 1. So we can say the mechanical advantage of class 1 lever may be equal to 1, less than 1, or greater than 1. Class 2 lever, here load is in between fulcrum and effort. And again, it is not necessary that load is in the midpoint of fulcrum and effort. It may be near effort or near fulcrum. So depending upon this, again, mechanical advantage and velocity ratio are greater than 1. For example, in this diagram you are able to see the effort arm, that is the distance of effort from the fulcrum, is always greater than the load arm, that is the distance of the load from the fulcrum, because the load is in middle or in between the effort and fulcrum. So in all the second class lever, the effort arm is always greater than the load arm. So in such kind of lever, the mechanical advantage is always greater than 1, because mechanical advantage is the ratio of effort arm upon load arm. Since the effort arm is greater than the load arm, so mechanical advantage will be greater than 1. Examples are nutcracker and bottle opener. See in the diagram of bottle opener and nutcracker, the load is in between fulcrum and effort. In class 3 lever, effort is in between fulcrum and load. And again, it is not necessary that effort is just at the midpoint or just in the middle of load and fulcrum. Here in the diagram, effort is in between fulcrum and load. So here, the distance of effort arm from fulcrum, that is the effort arm, is always less than the load arm, that is the distance of load from the fulcrum. Since the effort arm is less than the load arm in case of third lever, so the mechanical advantage is less than 1. The examples are sugar tong and knife. In the diagram, you are able to see the effort is applied in between the fulcrum and load. Students, on the basis of the topics taught, I am leaving some assignment work for you to complete. Thank you.